Ever since I published the video of building a parametric wall art, which is one of the better performing videos on my channel, I have received a lot of comments and direct messages asking me to show the design process. So in this video, I will show you my way of designing a parametric wall art. I am using a SketchUp for my design. To begin the design, we need to know the width and the height of our final product. In this example, I chose my product to be 30 inches tall and 6 inches wide. First, I draw my first vertical board. Let's call this vertical board a slat. The height of this slat is equal to the height of the final product. And the width of this slat, which is the depth of our final product, is not definitive at this point because we are going to change it later in the design process. For now, I want it to be 4 inches. The next step is to divide this slat into 1 inch tall sections. To do that, I choose the top edge of the slat, hold the control key and drag and drop it on the bottom edge. Then I type divide by 30 and it gives me 30 1 inch tall sections. Next, I need to make copies of this slat. To figure out the number of copies, we need to do a simple calculation. I am going to use 3/4 inch plywood for the slats and I want a 3/4 inch gap between each slat. That means the distance from the vertical edge of one slat to the same vertical edge of the next slat is 1.5 inches. Divide 60, which is the width of our final product, by 1.5, and we get 40, which is the number of slats we need. To make 40 copies, simply select the whole slat, press M for move, hold the control key, and copy a clone with a distance of 60 inches. Now divide it by 39, and you will get 40 slats, including the first slat. Next, we need to select everything and group them. Now, here is where the magic happens. For the final stage of our design, we are going to install an extension from the SketchUp extension warehouse. I already have that extension, but to install it, simply open the extension warehouse and search for Sketchy FFD Classic. Go ahead and install it. Once it is installed, make sure it is enabled in the extension manager. Then select your design, right-click on it, and select FFD. Then select N by N FFD. In the newly opened window, you need to enter 3 different values for 3 different dimensions. Depending on how you have designed your model, width, depth, and height can mean different things. But here basically width, depth, and height correspond to the red, green, and blue axes respectively. You need to fill out these fields with the number of dots you want for each axis. Since we only want to change the front face of the model and not the back face, for the width, I would suggest just entering 2. For the depth and height, it is totally up to you how detailed you want it to be. But remember, the higher the number of dots, the heavier your model will be to render. Here I enter 2 for width, 20 for depth, and 10 for height. Leave subdivide as false and select OK. Give it a few seconds and then you will have these dots on your model. To manipulate these dots more easily, I suggest you hide your model. Also, as I said, since we do not change the back face of our model, you can hide the dots on the back face as well. After all that, you're left with these dots. Your model is still here and you can unhide it to check the changes. What we want to do with these dots is to select one or many of them at once and just move them back and forth. Do not move them up and down or left and right, just back and forth. Now, If you unhide the model, you can see a smooth transition between the high spots and the low spots. Now, based on your imagination, you can just play with these dots, moving them back and forth until you find your desired shape. Now, here is the tricky part. You have a 3D model, but you need to cut each slat in 2D. So what you need to do is to export each slat in 2D. In order to do that, what I would do is create a separate component out of each slat and then export them in 2D. Change your camera angle so you can view the model from the side. And to get the best result, it is better to change the view of the camera from perspective to parallel projection. Now, you see the leftmost slat first. Triple click on it and press G on your keyboard to create a component. I suggest naming it by numbers so you don't miss the count. After that, hide the first slat, which is now a component, and repeat this process until you have 40 separate components for all 40 slats. Now, we need to export each slat individually in 2D. To do that, unhide the first slat while others are hidden. Then from top menu, select File, select Export, and select 2D Graphics. In the open window, select the location where you want to save your file and save it as a JPG file. Now, hide the first slat and unhide the second one. Repeat this process until you export all of the slats as JPG files. From here, it is totally up to you how you want to cut the slats, but just for the sake of demonstration, I will show you my process. Since I have a Shapeoko CNC, I will use Carbide Create to design and create toolpaths. My model's height is 30 inches, so I set my stock dimensions to 31 by 31. My files are JPGs, so I need to trace the images. To do that, I choose the Trace Image tool and select my first image. Then choose Trace so the software traces the border of my image, and when I click OK, it imports the shape. Here I can scale up the shape to be 30 inches tall, and do some cleanup. Then I repeat this process for other images as well. Here on this board, I can fit only 4 slats, and I type a number on each slat so I don't miss the order. Alright, I hope this tutorial was helpful. If you have any question or suggestion, please let me know in the comments. As always, thank you all for watching, and I will see you in the next one.